Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. It was a pretty busy week. We had strong earthquakes, we had major earthquakes, and it actually all started on the 10th. If you look at the SGI graph, we see pretty much a clustering of strong earthquakes following the convergence of critical planetary geometry on the 20th and the 21st, as I discussed in the previous update. And we also see this magnitude 7.7, and that was 2 days after the lunar peak on the 17th. And we go back to the 10th, or actually the 9th, you can look up that forecast as well, because there was a real convergence of critical planetary geometry, more than one actually. If we look at the 10th, we had a 7.5 magnitude earthquake right there with the planetary peak. And then on the 13th, 14th, I marked that as very critical planetary geometry in a convergence associated with really major earthquakes. We had earthquakes right there approaching magnitude 6, and then we had this magical lunar peak on the 17th that I also mentioned, and it was followed by a 6.4 at Guatemala. Then this magnitude 7.7 happened 2 days after that lunar peak. Now the 2 days following that lunar peak is not a surprise, and it happened within 4.5 days of the planetary geometry in a convergence on the 13th, 14th. And sometimes we have that time for about 4.5 days. It really depends on the synchronicity between the planetary geometry, in this case on the 13th, 14th, and the lunar peak following 3 days later. And as you can see, the 7.7 was followed by a series of strong earthquakes, including aftershocks. But then we go to the 20th and the 21st, the critical planetary geometry that I explained in the previous forecast. Magical geometry, in my opinion, and it was followed by a magnitude 6.8 at the Prince Edward Islands region, just south of Africa. And then we had additional strong earthquakes, and even this morning a magnitude 6.5, 6.6 at the Panama-Colombia border region. Okay, so what to expect in the coming days? We had really clustering of critical planetary geometry starting on the 10th of May, and it isn't over yet. If we look at the SGI graph, we see again planetary conjunctions coming up on the 31st, on June 1st and June 2nd. That is three critical planetary conjunctions in 3 days. If we look at the solar system, we see Mars, Mercury and Saturn coming up in a conjunction. We have Venus, Mercury and Neptune coming up. And then also Venus, Sun and Jupiter. All three conjunctions are critical. And in addition, we have a 90 degree angle with Venus involving Earth and Jupiter. And that all happens from May 31st to June 2nd. We can expect, again, major seismic activity, a convergence of these kind of planetary conjunctions can result in a major to great seismic event, high 7 to 8 magnitude. The Venus-Mercury-Neptune conjunction alone can already result in a high 7 magnitude earthquake. And on top of that, on June 4th, we have a full moon. So this convergence of critical planetary geometry precedes the full moon on June 4th. And that's pretty much a similar situation to what we had on 4 or 5 February, just prior to the major earthquakes in Turkey. Whether or not we are going to have major seismic activity again depends on the condition of Earth's crust, the amount of stress, whether or not there is a fault section, a major fault section with a really high amount of stress, critical amount of stress, that is pretty much set to go. But the convergence of planetary geometry that we have here can trigger large seismic activity, we know that. I will come back to this geometry in the next update, because I also want to show what is the geometry that we're going to have following this critical convergence. For now, we have a view of the SGI graph for the coming days, but keep in mind that critical planetary geometry later on, because we can have a really serious seismic increase at the time of that geometry and following that geometry. This was the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.